Adidas Bearcade is back. One of the most iconic tennis shoes in history gets its 12th update. The Adidas Bearcade remains true to its name with excellent stability thanks to the torsion system TPU shank and high durability due to an Adiwear rubber compound in the outsole. The 2021 edition of the shoe features a full-length bounce 2.0 in the midsole for a comfortable ride and a redesigned prime green upper made from recycled content. I was really happy to see the return of the Bearcade. Now, as expected, these did require a slight break-in period, a little bit shorter than the previous generations. For me, it was about 3 to 4 hours before they really broke in. And once I got them on court, they felt more lightweight and less clunky than the previous generations, but they still offer that really great torsional stability that I love in a Bearcade. I was moving side to side with confidence, and the outsoles are actually fairly slick, so I was able to slide in and out of my shots with great stability. Now, speaking of the outsole, these are very Bearcade-like, super durable. I put about 15 hours on them and they still show plenty of tread left. But it wasn't all good news with this shoe. I was getting a little bit of toe jamming. It really happened during that initial break-in period and then maybe only one or two times after that, but it is still something to be aware of. And I was also getting some rubbing on my heel and I could feel it through my crew sock. So if you like to wear no-shows, it can be an issue. But overall, really happy to see that the Bearcade is back. And I think if you were a big fan of the Bearcades of the past, this one is gonna check a lot of boxes.
I grew up in Bearcades, so I was really excited to get on court with these new ones. I'll touch on a couple of similar points to Jay. I did have some rubbing right off the bat, right around my ankle, so I did blister a little bit. Remedied that with double pair of socks throughout the rest of the playtest, and I was totally fine. The only other downside I have on this shoe would be the eyelet. I wish they had one more eyelet a little further up the ankle, that way I could really feel locked in. But that being said, the rest of the playtest and the rest of the shoe was really great. It checked all the boxes I wanted otherwise. Traction was great. I've had a couple of knee surgeries, so traction for me is super important, and I felt like these had a really well-balanced grip and slip. After that break-in period, again, like Jay said, right around like the 2-3 hour mark. Beyond that, stability was really nice, as well as durability. This is, for me, a kind of a classic Bearcade in that department. I couldn't wear through these at all with 25 plus hours on the shoe. So overall, again, just aside from a couple slight downsides, I was really happy with the playtest and I'll continue to wear these.
If you've been an avid tennis player for more than the last decade, you're probably familiar with an Adidas Bearcade. A lot of people were really disappointed when Adidas kind of took this shoe out of their lineup. Now the reintroduction of the shoe, I gotta say it's one of the more highly evolved versions of the shoe. I really like the Novak 7 and the 8. They opened up a little bit and they weren't so narrow. This shoe is gonna be very reminiscent in terms of durability, stability. It does require a little bit of a break-in time to get the ultimate comfort level out of it, but not as long as the traditional Bearcade, you know, the prior models. Sage alluded to kind of the proper amount of grip and slip. I played with this shoe over the tournament over the weekend, played with it on multiple hard courts, whether they're clean or not, have had great traction. So overall, very comfortable shoe, very supportive and durable. Obviously, it's living up to that Bearcade name. And if you're looking for that Bearcade feel, you're not gonna be disappointed with this shoe. And now from one very hot area of the country to even a hotter area, we're gonna toss this review off to Andrew in Atlanta.
Thanks, guys. I was very excited to try out the new Adidas Bearcade. I've used many generations in the past. I did not do the 18, but I used pretty much all the models before that. And right off the bat, what I noticed is it has that very familiar sort of feel in terms of stability, support. But one thing I noticed is it does have a little bit of added cushioning, which for me, I wasn't remembering as much in those previous generations. I have a flat foot, so I tend to play with lower arches. However, with the Bearcades, they do have a little bit more arch support than what I'm typically used to. And I'm happy to also report that I'm not getting any blistering in my arches and it feels pretty comfortable even with that extra support. I'm noticing that as I push off, I'm staying on that outside of my foot like I should be. So the arch support for your flat foot people out there, it's not gonna be where it's digging into your foot, but it will help you add a little bit of support. So good job from Adidas going with that nice medium, low medium arch support there. For stability, no issues at all on the court. I tend to be more of an aggressive mover and I found myself never stumbling over, never turning on my ankles. So the stability is very nice, right up to par with where it should be for a Bearcade. And then kind of going into the lacing system that you're seeing here, it is a little bit of an offset lacing system intended to help with sliding, kind of making sure that you're not digging into any of that lacing if you're a big hardcore slider. For me, what I found is the eyelets, it's not very forgiving if you're somebody who likes to use like a runner's loop like I like to use on pretty much all my shoes to keep my heel locked in place. So that would really be my only gripe with the lacing system is I wish I could do a little bit more with that loop system. If I were to have one complaint on the shoe itself, I am getting a little bit of wear on the inside of the ankle. I asked our other playtesters if they were seeing that wear, but they are not seeing that. So I don't know if it's just my shoe or the way I have it laced up. It's not affecting the playability of the shoe, but it does affect the cosmetic. As well, it does have a break-in period. So that's something that, you know, is typically expected from these heavier court shoes. But it did take a while for these to break in to the point where it was really molded to my foot. So overall, it's probably not gonna be one that I would switch to permanently, but this is a really solid shoe from Adidas in that Barricade line that is really worth checking out. Very comfortable, very stable, and very durable. That concludes our review of the Adidas Barricade. For more information on the shoe and many others, be sure to check out Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, and Tennis Only.